Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 8.1, Problem 2. This is Section 8.1, Problem number 2. It says, people's body temperature is normally distributed with a mean of 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit and a standard deviation of 0.8 degrees. So, Part A is, the size of the sample important in determining if the distribution of sample means is normal? So, sometimes you need a big enough sample, 30 or more, to ensure that your distribution of sample means is normal. In this case, we don't. The answer is no. Now, the reason why is the population that we're sampling from is normally distributed. If you know the population is normally distributed, doesn't matter how big your sample is, the distribution of sample means will be normally distributed. Now, if you're not sure if your population is normally distributed, then you need to have a sample size of at least 30, and the sample has to be taken randomly. But for this particular problem, because the population is known to be normally distributed, the answer to A is no. The size of the sample is really not important in making sure that the distribution of means is normal. B says, what do you expect the mean temperature to be for a random sample of 16 people? So, if you just take any random sample of 16 people and find their average temperature, it's going to come out to the same as the average of the whole population. The whole population has a mean of 98.6, so if you take a sample, you can expect it to have the same mean. The mean of the sample can be expected to be the same as the mean of the population. So the population is 98.6, the sample will have a mean of 98.6. What do you expect the standard deviation to be for a random sample of 16 people? So now, the population in general has a standard deviation of 0.8, but once you start taking samples, it gets a little bit different, and what it amounts to is the standard deviation from the mean of one sample to the next sample is really what we're looking for. And there's a formula for that. It's the standard deviation of the whole population, which we represent with the Greek letter sigma, over the square root of n, the size of the sample. Now again, as you make the sample bigger and bigger, you're dividing this by a bigger and bigger result, giving a smaller and smaller standard deviation overall. So the standard deviation for the population is given to be 0.8. The sample in this case, they say, is 16. So it's not 16 in the denominator, it's square root of 16. So now 0.8 over square root of 16 is 4. So 0.8 divided by 4 is 0.2. So if you take a sample of 16 people, the standard deviation among that sample will be 0.2, less than the standard deviation of the overall population. So, what is the probability that any one randomly selected person has a temperature of over 99 degrees? So just one person from the whole population, what's the probability that they have a temperature of over 99 degrees. So for any of these problems, what we need to do is use the standard normal chart and look something up, and what you need to look up is the Z value. So I can't look up a 99 degree temperature, the chart doesn't work that way. So I do X minus the mean over the standard deviation. So for the overall population, the X, the number I want to convert for, is 99 minus the mean of the whole population is 98.6 divided by the standard deviation. So we want the standard deviation for the population. We're just thinking of one person. It's not a sample. So 0.8. So 99 minus 98.6 will be positive 0.4 over 0.8. Well, I can reduce this without a calculator. You can cancel the decimals, really. 4 over 8 is a half. A half can be written as 0.5. So that's the Z value. It's positive 0.5. So now if I look up 0.5 in the chart, Step one to look up any value in the chart is write the number to look up so that it has two places after the decimal. So the 0.5 is written as 0.50. Now it has two places after the decimal. The next step is to split the number to look up into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. The zero comes off to the side. Then the third step is put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. And now what you do, the last step, is you go to the 0.5 row and intersect it with the 0, 0 column, and you will get 0.6915. That's what the chart says when you look up 0.5 or 0.50. Now, this is not the final answer. The question for part D, they want the probability that someone has a temperature of over 99 degrees or greater than. So for any type of greater than question, the answer is 1 minus the chart value. So for D, I have to do 1 minus 0.6915, which comes out to 0.3085. It's almost a 31% chance that any one randomly selected person from the population would have a temperature of over 99 degrees. Now, E, what is the probability that a random sample of 25 people will have an average temperature of over 99 degrees? So the average for the sample is over 99. It's a similar process, but the way in which you fill in the Z formula, the Z score formula, is a little different. So let me just make some room. I'll get rid of the work for D, and this will be for E. So I still have to find a z-value to look up a z-score. So now the x, the number I want a z-score for, is still 99. Minus the mean of any sample coming from a normal distribution will be the same as the mean of the whole population. So your sample should have a mean of 98.6, the same mean as the population mean. So the top of the z-score formula looks the same. But now the denominator is different. It's not the 0.2 that I had before. In part C, I was looking at a sample size of 16. This is a little bigger sample size for E. So it's 25. So I'm going to do the standard deviation for samples of 25 at a time. It's going to be the population standard deviation of 0.8 divided by the square root of the sample size, that same sigma over square root of n that I used in part C, and that's the standard deviation for samples of size 25. So the top is easy, 99 minus 98.6. The numerator will be 0.4, and underneath I'll have 0.8 divided by square root of 25 is 5. So I can further simplify the denominator. Let me simplify that, 0.8 divided by 5. I can see it's 0.16. So I'm going to have 0.4 over 0.16. That's the computation I need to do for my z-score. Now I can see that's 2.5. If you can't see it easily, just take your calculator and do the top 0.4 divided by the bottom 0.16. And the calculator will tell you it's 2.5. That's the z-score. That's what we look up. So 2.5, look that up in the chart. Step one, write the number to look up so that it has two places after the decimal. So that 2.5 gets written as 2.50. Now it has two places after the decimal. After that, you're going to split the number to look up into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So the last zero comes off to the side. Step three, you put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. So instead of just a plain old zero, it's 0.00. Now for the final step, you go to the 2.5 row for this particular problem, positive 2.5, again, not negative. The 0, 0 column will be the first one, and it'll say 0.9938. That's where the 2.5 row and the 0.00 column intersect. That's the value from the chart. Now, depending on how they ask the question, that might be our final answer, or we might have to do 1 minus the chart value. So as you read through, it says over 99 degrees. That's like a greater than. So if it said less than 99.99 degrees, the answer from the chart would be the answer, and we'd be done. But because it says over 99 degrees, we have to do 1 minus the charge value, 1 minus 0.9938, which would be 0.0062. It's less than 1%. So the probability of taking a random sample of 25 people and having the average of that sample be over 99 degrees is very unlikely, even though it's pretty close to the regular temperature. So one person over 99, not that unlikely, almost 31% chance. A sample of 25 with an average of over 99, very unlikely, less than 1%.